What if your teaching assistant asked you,
"How does this little box work internally?"
What are you going to say? Overload relays are sometimes called thermal overloads. These are probably the most popular type of overload protection. In melting alloy type, the motor current passes through a small heater winding. The heat causes a special solder to melt, allowing a ratchet wheel to spin. And this opens the control circuit contacts. Here is an example of this mechanism. This is a three-phase overload relay with a three heater elements. When the heater element is removed, we can see the geared wheel.
Is that all you got?
No. Another extremely common thermal mechanism is a bimetallic strip. This design uses a bimetal strip connected with a current carrying heater coil. When an overload occurs, the heat causes the bimetal to deflect and turn on a tripping mechanism, which opens a set of contacts in the control circuit, interrupting power to the coil and opening the power contacts. Let me ask you, did you hear about thermal memory and the recent problem of the overload? Due to the increasing nature of the heat, the overloads that are previously triggered will trip sooner because of something commonly called a thermal memory. Motor damage can happen if the overload relays repeatedly reset without correcting a cause of the overload event. Ambient temperature can greatly affect the tripping time of the thermal overload relay, unless overload includes some means of balancing for ambient temperature. Man, don't run away and tell me, what is this? Alright, this is also an electronic overload relay that use a current transformer mounted on each phase that directly measure current. Internal circuitry calculates the temperature based on a user adjustable setting and will trigger the feedback contact of the overload to open in case of a continuous overload. Advanced electronic overload relays offer other functions in addition to over temperature detection, including instantaneous overcurrent, ground fault, phase loss and imbalance, plus over or under voltage protection and more. Man, when I tried to buy an overload relay, he asked me, "Which class number does you want, sir?" And I didn't know what to say. Okay, overloads are known by their class number. The class number indicates how long an overload takes to trip when carrying a current equal to 6 times its current setting. A class 10 relay will trip in 10 seconds or less when carrying a current equal to 6 times its rating. A class 20 relay will trip in 20 seconds or less when carrying a current equal to 6 times its rating. A class 20 overload relay would be suitable for applications with high initial loads. Manufacturers should supply a graph that shows a tripping time as a function of current. As an example, consider an adjustable class 10 overload relay that has been set to 3 amps. The graph shows it would take around 30 seconds to trip if it was carrying 4 times 3 amps or 12 amps. That's it. We will make use of this device in later videos. See you then. Cheers.